Imagine this. A system that is in motion is thrown completely out of balance by an injury and then repairs itself completely on its own. That really is fascinating for me. I am Catherina Becker, and I am researching the successful regeneration of the spinal cord in zebrafish.
Our body is in a constant state of change. Its regeneration possibilities appear to be almost infinite. With the help of stem cells, many organs continuously form new cells. Especially after injuries, damaged tissue can repair itself quickly. But there are limits to regeneration in the human body.
If the nervous system is injured and a function is completely lost and then restored, that's something we humans can't do. But frogs can do that, salamanders can do that, and fish can do that too. The fact that you can bring a system out of balance like this and then a function is completely restored again, that has always fascinated me.
Edinburgh was Catherina Becker's home and research environment for 16 years. Here she was able to gain groundbreaking insights into how nerve cells can develop anew and help heal damaged tissue. With her team, she works on zebrafish, an important model organism for research. This is because their embryos are almost completely transparent, and their developmental steps can be easily traced. They have a high genetic similarity to mammals. Of special interest for regeneration research is, once the spinal cord is severed, the zebrafish regains its ability to swim again after only 6 weeks.
What I ultimately want to understand is how this restoration of function can work. What is possible? Imagine that such a data highway is severed. At that moment, many things happen. First of all, there is a lot of junk lying around that has to be cleared away. The other thing that happens is that many nerve cells die as a result of the injury and have to be replaced. There are stem cells in the spinal cord of the fish that recognize that there has been an injury and they start to produce new nerve cells. That doesn't happen in humans.
The messenger substance dopamine, commonly known as the happiness hormone, predominantly serves the communication of nerve cells with each other. But the team was able to find out that it has another function as well. In a way, it converses with the stem cells in the spinal cord and can stimulate the production of new motor neurons. These contribute to the rewiring of the spinal cord and thus make the motor function of swimming possible again.
As a scientist, it's always a journey you go on. It's super exciting to discover that there really is a completely new substance that no one knew about yet, and that it creates new nerve cells in the spinal cord. That automatically expands your intellect and allows you to think further and broader. It also gives you the courage to pursue other signaling pathways and look at what role they play in regeneration.
The amazing thing is, during neurogenesis, the formation of new nerve cells, the nervous system in the zebrafish is not exactly recreated. This is a dogma that prevailed in science for many years. After an injury in the spinal cord, a completely new system is created in which possibly only one-third of the original nerve fibers are restored. The system is repaired with new building blocks and with what the stem cells can produce. At the CRTD, Catherina Becker finds new food for thought and inspiration from a change of environment. At the Center for Regenerative Therapies, she would like to continue her research into the molecular and cellular mechanisms involved in neurogenesis, a field of research that also provides the opportunity to build bridges into medical therapeutic fields of application.
The fact that we cannot regenerate has an enormous impact in many areas. It doesn't have to be a spinal cord injury. It can be a stroke or a neurodegenerative disease, for example. This really does put a complete strain on us. If you look around in your circle of acquaintances, in your circle of friends, you will always find someone who would benefit immensely if their nervous system could regenerate. And in this respect, of course, it is also a motivation.
New research axes emerge in exchange with Dresden colleagues such as Humboldt professor Michael Sieveker. There is, for example, the work on macrophages, cells of the immune system, and the different roles they play in the regeneration of humans and zebrafish. Catherina Becker can make new connections here and, at the same time, build on her own strengths.
What I personally find most exciting is to see something new, something that no one has ever seen before. To calmly see a phenomenon where I think, now that looks exciting. To formulate an idea that could work in such and such a way is super exciting. And if what you have discovered then has general significance and is actually transferable to other species in other situations, then that is, of course, excellent.
This research gives hope that human nerve tissue can be repaired at some point in the future.